this thing. Friday, 1756, 37 seconds, year 2023, 6 month, June, 30th day. And here's the old Whimmy Jimmy here. I didn't test this one thoroughly when I threaded it in there, but oh well. At least I got it in there somewhat for now. Yeah, got everything on here. Just gonna put this on. Seen a contraption like this. This is pure custom, man. Pure custom. The most thoroughly diligent tested. Get tight enough. That's all I need right there. Well, got a water cap up here. I can fill it with water. So it's actually all ready to test now. So I just get all this stuff out of the way, put it away, and that way it doesn't get all wet. Put this stuff away over that. I shall be back. I don't like to say I will be back because that's I will. I like to replace that with I shall. cap. This has got a nice thread in it. I just realized it. Looks like a three-quarter. Yeah. I could put this faucet in here, hopefully. Look at that. Freaking faucet fits right in it. Holy shit. That's a bonus. And I could shut that all the way off. Alright, I can disconnect this. I need to get another set of these channel locks. These are coming apart. Like that. It'll be a bit loose, but at least it's something I can get a little test with it. Okay, and then I just have to open it up to get any water. Otherwise, it'll just leak out there with the pressure. Or it should just come, start squirting out right out the top of that well pump. So, yeah, so as long as I got that shut off, it should be wonderful. Of course, it is leaking. So is this valve. It's a shitty valve. See if it'll tighten. That one tightened a little. That one tight. So. See if these ones will tighten.
Get that little tight there. Flapper from this, that's right. That's what it is. Ah, but I fill it up right here, so this should be already full. This right here, I just fill. Yeah, so this is already full here. But let me get that. Let me get this over here. There we are. Just mixing those together. Okay. So this should be already full right here. This pipe here. And this valve is hooked to the hose. I open this up and this should fill this hole. It'll fill the pump housing. And it should come out the top of the well. The pump. Up there should the theory go. So I'll turn this on. Yeah, it already was on. Hold on a second. There we are. I heard it crack. Should be filling the tank. And just wait for it to come out the top here. Yeah, there it goes. I had to pump it. Alright, so that's wonderful. Water coming out of it. Now shut it off. It should shut down. Now turn it on again. Coming out. Alright, shut it off. Now the idea is to see if there's any leaks from here to here. This right here, I'm gonna have to just disconnect that because that's already leaking, but at least I got filled with water and I had pressure enough to push it up through there. That's all I wanted to see was happening, so I don't need the pressure anymore, so I'll just disconnect that. pressure in the hose. Suppose if I pump some of it, that'll help it turn the, open the valve. Ah, there it is. Just gotta open the valve. That's it. Alright. Well. This out. Set. Put the plug back in. Let's seal everything up. And this valve here, well, let's get a little closer here. Let me go from the back here. All right. See, I'm gonna be over here. So I'll open this valve. Get a little more. Well, more this way. So, have to get more headroom in there. Down so I can see the valve. Yeah. So open this one. Now if the water was low in this, when I open it up, water should go down in this tank here. But if it was full, this tank should still be full. Which, yes, it is. Well, no, it won't, because there's a flapper in here. Yeah. There's a flapper that only goes one way. It only opens to go exit out or to suck into the machine. So the only way I figured that was out because I had pulled this whole plate off right here. As I was, you know, that was the only option to be able to figure out how to get this thing together. I had to know what was on the other side and all that contraption stuff. So that's open. This is sealed, so there should be enough water to where. Let me put this brick down here so I don't just wear the hell out of the dirt. Actually, I put a bucket there so it doesn't splash all over the place. Let me get a bucket. bucket. So there. That'll be more wonderful. I got distracted and when I went into the rain shed looking for a bucket, I had to chase a couple fucking bumblebees that were in there. They got a little nest in the firewood, so I gotta fucking scatter them. Anyway, okay, so this is open. So now I could slowly crack this one to the main pipe. And then just start pumping. And see if it'll continue. So I'll open the valve more. This is good news so far. Open it more. I got it pretty much fully open. I got continuous water going through the pump from underneath the earth into the ground. And it's not letting up. So this tells me that if this motor was running, supposedly it should be pulling water right out of the ground. Unless for some reason this motor is weaker than this pump. So, with all that said and wonderfully accomplished, I'm going to shut the ground off as I'm continuing to pump so nothing goes down. All right. So, I'm going to shut everything, all the valves off. The pump valve, I got three valves. The pump valve, the ground valve, and the primary well pitcher valve. Three valves for this thing. This is just the test pitcher. So, all these clamps are holding. Everything is sealed. So, the next test is going to be hook the fire hose up. That's wonderful. That's wonderful news, man. That's news worth reporting as far as I'm concerned. That should be on the 6 o'clock evening news, man. Passed around into the air everywhere with what, you know. But I even accomplished it without spilling water all over the ground. That was wonderful. All right. So the next project, you know, once I get the fire pump and the hose running, and I'm running around the backyard testing out the fire hose, with I figure I'll get at least a 30-foot shot of water coming out the end of that hose. Reason being is because there's 15 foot of rock in this well, which is actually kind of a blessing. Because that allows that pipe to prime real quick. Otherwise, you know, if I finally got to the point where, you know, I could figure out that this thing would just draw up water no matter what, then according to the calculations, you know, just running this pump in a regular river, get a 60-foot shot out the end of that hose. That's pretty much to the top of them trees up here. So that fire catches top of these trees up here, I'll be able to quickly put them out. Supposedly, that's the plan. And you know, if it's in the back of the fence in the bike path or in the neighbor's yard or whatever, I'll at least be able to put half their house out so it won't jump the fence line. They'll just lose half the house. So just, you know, if I'm not saying it's gonna happen, I'm just being down to earth and reality with training, you know, that's the way it is. But you know, for all I know, it could be so fucking smoky I won't be able to fucking stand it, even with a smoke rat, with a smoke mask, you know. That's, it could be. But I figure if I got water spraying in the air, that'll at least put some oxygen in the air, make it easier to breathe. So look at that. And that just came to me just now, just because I audited it and spoke it into the air. All of a sudden, the new thought, the idea entered the brain and said, ah, yeah, throwing water in the air would put more oxygen around this area. And that was one of the things I was concerned with, being smoked out. But anyway, so I'm going to shut the video for this opportunity here. And there's going to be other tests too, you know. So I got different tests that I want to. But anyway, like